G'day, my name is Russ Weakley from Max Design. Today I'm going to give a quick demonstration of how to use the inspect element functionality within your browser. And I'm also going to teach you how you can save any inspect element work that you've done in the browser. Inspect element is a powerful function that you can use from inside the browser. It allows you to do all sorts of things, and they include things like looking at specific elements on the page and their relationship to other elements. You can see all the CSS related to specific elements and even check the specificity or weight of different selectors and how they're being applied. You can also do things like editing the HTML and CSS and even content changes on web pages to see how things will affect the layout. Now, most modern browsers have some sort of inspect element functionality. For this demo, I'm going to use Chrome, but most of the functionality you'll see should be able to be used in any modern browser. So here's a sample web page, and the first question you probably ask is, how do I access Inspect Element? Well, we can do it by clicking on any element, so we could choose this H2 element, and right-click on it, and choose Inspect Element. And immediately that will bring up our Inspect Element functionality. Now, the first thing you'll notice is there are three main panels, I suppose. The first one is the element panel. Over at the right is the CSS panel, or the styles panel, and you can actually change the width of each of these panels. And down here is our pathways panel. Now, there are also a bunch of other options that you can delve into, but we're really going to focus on elements, the styles, and pathways. Down in the bottom left corner, depending on the browser, there'll be some sort of functionality where you can pop this out into a separate window, and in some cases you can even put it beside the page instead of below it. And you can also trigger it to go back. You'll notice as we drag through the elements that they're being highlighted on the page. And that allows us to see exactly what we're working on at the moment. Now, we can choose to navigate by clicking on different items, but we could also do it using the arrows key. So I can move down and up through the various elements, but I can also use the arrow keys to open elements. So if I use the right arrow on the nav element, I've now opened it up and I can see the UL. And if I right arrow again, I can see the LI inside. And inside that, I can see the A element. So you can use the arrow keys to open and close elements, as well as moving up and down. Now, one thing you'll notice is that you may want to work on some element like the footer, which is not actually in view. And you can right click on that and click scroll into view. And immediately that element will come up into the page area so it can be seen. The next thing we're going to look at is how to actually edit the HTML inside the browser. Now, if we click on our H2 element and scroll into view, you can see it up here. Now, we can actually edit a range of things around this element. But keep in mind, they're dynamically generated, meaning that as soon as we refresh the page, these changes will disappear. But the first thing we could do is actually change this from an H2, for example, to an H1. And what we can do is click Edit as HTML. Again, we can access this by right-clicking. And here we can change that 2 to a 1. And if we click off, you'll see that our H2 has now become an H1 element. So we can edit the HTML and change it to whatever we want. And you'll see just by changing one of them, it'll automatically change the end tag as well. Another thing we can do is to add an attribute. So we might want to put a class here, and we can put in class something. And now we've added a class to that element. Now, if there are existing classes, you can edit or modify them by double-clicking onto that element, onto that attribute. So in this case, we might want to change it to nav2, in which case it will suddenly become unstyled. And of course, at any point, we can just reload, and the page will go back to the way it was. we can actually also change the content inside an element. So as an example, we have the word home here. We could change that to something. And now that element, the content inside that element has changed. And again, as soon as we reload, it goes back. We can also drag and drop elements and move them to a new location. So our last element here is called Contact Us. If I close that, I can actually click on the arrow and drag it and move it to a different location. And now, Contact Us is sitting as the first item in the list. So we can drag and drop elements. Now let's look over at our styles components. Again, if we want to go back and find our H2 element, so we'll click on that and go inspect element, we can now see any of the styles associated with that element. So it just so happens inside I'm actually highlighting a span, and the span has a class of color 1. It's also inside an H2, so you can see that other styles like H2 and these other ones are also being affected. Now this is a great way to see all of the styles that affect any element. This tool is a great learning tool to understand how CSS is used and applied by browsers. Now at any stage, we could turn off a declaration. So if I uncheck that color, you'll see the word about has gone black, and I can turn that back on. I can also edit the property, so I could do something like padding, and I could change that to, and now I've changed this to padding 10px. So it was color, and I've changed both the property and the value. And of course, I can reload at any time to get it back to the way it was. You can also choose to add a new rule, and you can do that by clicking the plus symbol here. And as you can see, it's generated a whole new rule, and we could do something like margin 10px. And now we've actually added a new rule there. And again, that's just generated on the fly, so if we reload the page, all of those different styles will disappear. Another thing we can do is to work on the state of an element. So if we were to look at this element up here called small cogs and inspect that element, you'll see that it's actually in the blue state. The background is blue until we hover over it. But if we go over here and turn on states, we could select the hover state, and then we'll actually see what it looks like in the various states. So in this case, it goes red when it's active, black when it's focused, orange or yellowy color when it's hovered, and there's no difference on visited. But what this allows you to do is to really check out how that rule is being applied in its various states. So a question you might be asking is, if you go into all this trouble to edit your HTML or your CSS, and it actually doesn't save anywhere, how could you save all that work you've just done? Well, you can with both your HTML and your CSS. Save a version of it. Now, it won't automatically overwrite your existing files, but you can save a version to your text editor and then overwrite existing files if you want. So first of all, let's have a look at our HTML file. And if we inspect element on our heading there, we could choose to change that text to whatever we wanted. And when we're done, the quickest way is just to click on the HTML element and right-click and do copy as HTML. And now you can paste that entire page straight into any text editor you want. And then you could use that and overwrite your existing file. Similarly, with your CSS, you could choose an element you want to edit. In this case, let's say the body. You might want it to be red as a background. And when that's done, you click on the actual link to the CSS file. In this case, it's called cog.css. And when that's been brought up, you can right-click on that and save as, and save this file down to any location you want, and overwrite your existing CSS file. So, in both the HTML and the CSS, it's quite quick and easy to copy any work that you've been doing directly in the browser. So there we have it, a very quick and dirty overview of the inspect element functionality. It's really important you play with this and get a handle on it, because it's such a simple and beautiful way to do CSS troubleshooting straight in the browser. If you'd like to learn more about CSS troubleshooting, to play around the elements I've used here, or even quiz yourself, maybe you should check out my new course called CSS Troubleshooting in 6 Easy Steps. It's on at learnable.com. This course is designed for beginners and those who've experienced CSS layout issues in the past. Hope to see you there.